Good afternoon. Friday, September 16th. Another beautiful day. The weather's just been so nice. And that's resulted in a really nice golf course as well. So congrats to all the club champs over the past weekend. I think we had a really successful setup. We hit our goals as far as green speed. We kept them around that 10, 10 and a half area. Today, we're very close to 11. Which is a little too quick. So I think we're gonna change our strategy up a little bit. This weekend will be a little less aggressive. Should get the green speed back down to the 10 and a half area. I know there's been a lot of compliments about the green speed, but I know representing the membership as a whole, we want to keep it around that 10 and a half area just to keep pace of play. But man, I tell you, it's really good conditions out here. All the way around, whether it's fairways, tees, collars, greens, roughs, really good shape, bunkers, good shape. The roughs we're mowing a little less frequently just to keep down on the wear and tear from seeded areas. So there might be a few tall spots out there, but overall, really playable, really good. So this week, we had our tree company grind the stumps of the trees that have been previously dropped. So 9 stumps were ground. All those grindings have been picked up and the holes have been filled in with soil. Some of those areas are areas of more construction. Number 6T, for an example, next to that fence line, we're gonna be doing quite a bit of work over there. Hopefully renovating those tees. We had some drainage issues back when we had the 10 and a half inches. Made a mess of that blue tee. Everything just drains onto the tee. We've got to get that tee elevated so we can get the water to go around it. That would be ideal. So that's in the works. So also this week, a lot more low limbing. I think we've done more low limbing on trees this year than we have any other year that I have been here. So all these trees have been getting their canopy raised, giving a lot more space for golf shots. And, you know, also importantly, a lot more space for sunlight to get through to our turf grass, as well as really important. Most people probably don't think about this, but all of our irrigation heads or down the rough lines, and you know, we've got some down, you know, a row down the fairways and then down the rough on the left and right. Well, if those tree canopies are really low, all those sprinklers get deflected, and so they're not reaching their full potential and they're not reaching their targeted areas, which right now we're pretty dry. You can see a staff member up watering that collar that's browned out. I was here on 18 fairway. I watered this area probably for about 30 minutes. But, you know, we're pretty dry, ready for some rain. But when those irrigation heads can't get the proper coverage, then we have issues with some areas being too wet because the water's been deflected and drained in one spot. And then areas that have not got any of that water is too dry. So really important on both the golf course management side as well as for golf playability. With low limb in these trees. So this would be an example of some trees that we haven't got to yet. So these trees are still pretty low. You can touch them with your hand. So they're about 7 foot, 8 foot. We'll be raising those up into that 15, 20 foot area. So we're gonna continue on that. Otherwise, just a little bit of this, a little bit of that. We're a little lower on staff. We had a few more staff members go back to school the last batch, so we're getting down to our fall staff, which basically means the only thing we stop doing is often our bunkers. So bunkers predominantly would be done on Tuesdays and Fridays and on weekends. So it's really important for members to rake yourselves out so that the next member can have a decent lie in that bunker. You know, bunkers take us generally about 4 hours with 3 staff members, so that's 12 labor hours. And those 12 labor hours we're going to need for blowing leaves and doing some projects and doing some mowing. So we're just going to allocate that labor a little differently and keep moving forward. But golf course is packed today, as it should be. Keep making tee times. Very important, if you've all made it this far, I hit my 5-minute mark, which I'm usually trying to be done by now. But if you made it this far, very important. We're not aerifying until after closing day classic. So greens are gonna be pristine for an entire month to come. So make tee times, get friends out here, get members of other golf courses out here to show off what we've got. So have a great weekend. We'll talk to you next week. Thanks. Bye-bye.